Hello, welcome back. Today we're going to be using this river cane here, or bamboo, to make a fish trap. I was over here the other day and harvested some, but I'm needing some more. So let's go ahead and get started on it.
Okay, now after you get your small one, you would want to cut right there underneath the node or behind the node, and then you would want to clean it out using one of the limbs. You would take your pocket knife or your other knife and clean out the node, you know, so it'd be hollow. And then you would take your stick and you would just stick down in there and clean out any debris that's left down in there. Now it should go from this node to this node. I'm just going to stick my limb down there, pinch it off, and pull it out. And that's exactly where it needs to be. Okay. Now, take your river cane and just bend it, doing it slowly. No rush for this. There's no need to rush. The slower you are, the better your circle is going to be. Okay, so I'm going to cut it about right there. See it hanging over, put the thumb there. Okay. Snap it off. You have something that looks something like that. Alright. Now you just take it. Bend it in on itself. Placing it on the inside of your reed. Place it in. Now you have your circle. It's very easy.
But to give you a close up of what I'm talking about, as you see the hole there, and there's the node. What you want to do is you want to take the end, get out here, and just place him in the hole. And then you have your ring. And once that dries, that'll shrink on itself and it won't come out.
Okay, it's taken me about 30 some minutes to get this far here. I'm going to take the snare wire, wrapping it around the river cane. I'm not worried about this in here because it's all going to be closed up in here. I'm going to take this other one that I made the other day and place in here and fashion the same thing. So it would be a vortex that they would have to come through. Now notice this ring here, but it'll all be closed together here. I'm not going to have a lid for it to come on and off, but I can stick my hand through here once I take the trap out of the water, let the fish be flopping around inside, that I can just reach in there and grab it. Like I said, it's a slow process. And it'll be continued to be fashioned like that. I'm taking these. I've already cut them to length where I think I would need them. I've been splitting them. Trying to split them, let's say that. To the proper length. So that it would be lighter for one, and then I get two sticks out of one. It's a very slow process. Very slow. Find my wire again. It'll take me off a piece, probably. I don't know, about 10 inches long. I'm going in this direction. I'm going to continue fashioning them on and around. So I'll begin here to the node. That way it doesn't come off. Take my wire, twist it around, leave a little tag in it. That way I can tie it up to it again. Place it. Just leave a little bitty gap so you can stick your wire through, and then once you get it tied, you can slide it down snug against the other one. If you had a bank line or paracord, you can tie them on with that. Which I have bank line right here. I'm just going to fasten them together like this at first. And then if I decide to keep it, then I'll spend a little bit more time on it and put it on bank line or paracord, either one. Okay, you have that one. Now you just come down to this side and do the same thing. Tag in that we can tie it onto itself. There you have it. Slow start. So let me get a little bit further and then I'll get back with you. Okay, you can see as of now, there's 24 reeds attached to this, which is halfway. You lay it down on the back side, it goes up halfway. So I went and I cut enough to have 25, hopefully enough to finish it on out. But fortunately, rain's got me, or it's coming in on me, and I have to stop. So there will be a part two of this. I was hoping to get it all in one segment, but Mother Nature says different. So we'll see you in part two. Have a great day.